गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, EVS 2 लेसन 7 स्वराज फर्स्ट कॉन्क्वेस्ट। व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ कॉन्क्वेस्ट? कॉन्क्वेस्ट मीन्स डोमिनेशन ऑफ कंट्रोल ऑफ अ प्लेस और पीपल बाय मिलिट्री फोर्स। इट इज़ नो डाउट ट्रू दैट शिवाजी एंड हिज कॉमरेड्स टुक द ओथ ऑफ स्वराज इन द टेम्पल ऑफ रायरेश्वर। वी हैव सीन इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर। बट इट वॉज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टास्क। In those days, Maharashtra was governed by four different powers: the Mughal Emperor of Delhi, Sultan Adil Shah of Bijapur, the Portuguese of Goa, and the Siddhi of Janjira. They were powerful opponents. Opponents, one that takes opposition firm in their authority, no one would dare utter a word against them. Under their difficult conditions, Shivaji had taken the oath of Swaraj. There was no comparison between the vast forces of enemy and a handful of Shivaji's maulas. But Shivaji's mind was made up and his firm resolve was his great source of strength. So, in those days, Maharashtra was governed by four different powers: Mughal Emperor of Delhi, Sultan Adil Shah of Bijapur, and Portuguese of Goa and Siddhi of Janjira. And all of them were powerful opponents. Torana Fort. Shivaji controlled the Jagir of Pune, Supet, Chakan and Indapur. All the forts in the Jagir were, however, in charge of the officers from the court of Bijapur. He who controlled the fort also controlled the surrounding territory, and therefore all talk of Swaraj without the control of forts was meaningless. A hill fort gave strategic support to the ruler, and Shivaji decided to capture one at a suitable time. Strategic means relating to the gaining of long-term military advantage. It gave a strategic support to the ruler, hill fort, and Shivaji decided to capture one of the suitable time. For this purpose, he had selected the fort of Torna. It stands to the southwest of Pune in the Kannad Valley. So where is the fort of Torna? Southwest of Pune in the Kannad Valley. It was a renowned fort, well suited for defense. There were two strong machis on the way to the fort. A machi is a fortification of natural plateau formed on the slope of a hill. What is fortification? Fortification is a defensive wall. So a machi is a fortification of natural plateau formed on the slope of a hill. One of these machis was the Junjar Machi and the other the Budla Machi. Junjar Machi, like its name, could offer powerful defense. Against the enemy. The only access to the fort was across the Junjar Machi. It is a very difficult passage with high hills on one side and deep valleys on other. A careless person may easily lose his balance and end his life in the deep valley. Torna was considered one of the strong forts of Maharashtra. In the fort there is a temple of goddess Toranjai. That is why the fort is called Torna. So, the Junjar Machi, it was a very difficult passage with high hills on one side and deep valleys on other. And a careless person may easily lose his balance. So, Torna was considered one of the strong forts in Maharashtra, and in that temple there was goddess Toranjai. That is why it was called as Torna. Strangely enough, this powerful fort was neglected by Adil Shah. There were neither enough troops for its defense nor enough ammunition. Shivaji knew this, and this was exactly what he wanted. So this fort was neglected by Adil Shah because there was no troops and no defense for ammunition. So Shivaji knew this, and it was exactly what he wanted. He decided to capture the fort and thus lay the foundation of Hindavi Swaraj. The drums of Swaraj begin to sound. With a few select bands of Maula, Shivaji descended into the Kannad Valley. Swift-footed like the deer and lion-hearted in courage, they raced to the top and captured the strategic positions in the fort. Tanaji Malsuri hoisted the Maratha flag at the main entrance. Yashji Kank, a trustworthy and loyal companion of Shivaji, posted his guards at important points. The fort was captured and almost without any resistance, and the sky was filled with shouts of Shivaji Maharaj Ki Jai. The first battle drums and the pipes of Hindavi Swaraj had sounded, and their echo reverberated throughout the valley. Shivaji named this fort as Prachandgarh. So in this way, Shivaji descended into Kannad Valley, swift-footed like the deer and lion-hearted in courage. They raised and captured all the strategic positions of the fort, and Tanaji Malsure hoisted the Maratha flag on the main entrance. Yashji Kank, a trustworthy, loyal companion of Shivaji, posted his guards at important point, and thus the fort was captured. And all shouted Shivaji Maharaj Ki Jai. The first battle drums and the pipes of Hindavi Swaraj sounded, and the echo was heard all throughout the valley. And Shivaji named this fort as Prachandgarh. Blessings of Goddess Bhavani. Fort Torana then came under Shivaji's administration. He made a very careful survey of it and appointed officers such as a Maratha Kiledar, a Brahmin Sabnis, and a Prabhu Karkhanis. The garrison included Mawlas, Kolis, Ramoshis, Mahars, and such brave men from many other castes and communities. In Swaraj, all castes and communities were to be treated alike, and no distinction was made on the basis of caste. In Swaraj, all were treated as equal, no distinction was made between caste and community. As repairs to the fort started, a surprise awaited the people. They discovered four metal pots filled to the brim with the mohurs. The workers were overjoyed. They said that this was a gift to Shivaji from Goddess Bhavani, who has blessed his efforts. All the money discovered was brought to Shivaji. No one thought of taking anything for himself. After all, it was the wealth of Swaraj. Shivaji felt greatly elated, and this unexpected gift, which would enable him to pursue his ideal of Swaraj with added vigor. He felt that it was working under the benevolent eye of Goddess Bhavani. There, when they were repaired started of the fort, they discovered four metal pots, and those pots were filled till the brim, till the edge with mohurs, and the workers were overjoyed. But they said that that was a gift from Shivaji from Goddess Bhavani, because she has blessed his efforts. And all the money discovered was brought to Shivaji. No one thought of taking that mohurs. After all, it was a wealth of Swaraj. And he felt that he was working hard. Benevolent means well-meaning and kindly. He felt that he was working under the benevolent eye of Goddess Bhavani. Shivaji utilized part of the treasure found in the fort to purchase arms and ammunition. The rest he decided to use for another project which he had already in his mind. About 15 kilometers to the east of Torana is the hill of Murumdev. Shivaji had his eye on it for a long time. This hill was steep and difficult to ascend, and therefore of great strategic importance. Adil Shah had actually started constructing a fort on this hill, but he let it unfinished. This hill also was not well guarded by Shivaji, and he decided to capture it. So one more fort was there, Murumdev, hill of Murumdev. Shivaji had his eye on it for a long time, and he decided to capture that hill also. The first capital of Swaraj. One day Shivaji climbed up the hill with a select band of his followers and took possession of partially completed fort. The money found on Torana was used to complete the fortifications of Murumdev. Shivaji named this fort as Raigarh. stone masons, carpenters, blacksmiths, water carriers, other workers, all the people got busy. They built the Raj Mahal, Bara Mahal and 18 workshops. Rajgarh became the first capital of Swaraj. Shivaji's rapid progress. From then onward, Shivaji moved swiftly and captured one fort after another in Mawal. The whole country known as Bara Mawal, the 12 Mawals, was overflowing with joy and excitement. The Patils and Deshmukhs from many villages came and swore allegiance to Shivaji. But Mawal had its own share of blacklegs who were ever ready to put a spoke in the fast-moving wheel of Swaraj. Jealous of Shivaji's success, they complained to Adil Shah, collector at Shirwal. The collector dispatched messengers to Bijapur and informed Adil Shah of Shivaji's rapid progress. Shivaji, the shrewd politician, Adil Shah was most surprised to get the news. He asked Shahaji Raje for an explanation. Shahaji Raje got himself out of this difficult situation by telling the Sultan that Shivaji Raje had probably taken over the fort for better administration of Jagir. Shivaji also sent his message to Sultan, "I have taken possession of fort for better administration of countryside. We did this only in the interest of Sultan. There was no evil design at the back of this action." So Adil Shah was surprised to get the news, and Shahaji Raje asked for explanation. Shahaji Raje got himself out of the difficult situation, telling the Sultan that Shivaji Raje had probably taken the fort for better administration of Jagir. The two forts of Kondana and Purandar too had strategic locations. Shivaji used his political skill and took control of both the forts. The two forts Kondana and Purandar had also strategic locations, and Shivaji used political skill and took control of both the forts. The next fort to come under his sway was Rohida. This was a fast work indeed, and there was nothing to stop Shivaji now. So he took in under possession forts of Kondana, Purandar, and now the next fort was Rohida.